Hello, my name is Tobin. I'm a microbiologist, and today I'm going to talk to you about the work that EFSA is doing in the area of emerging risks. So, what are emerging risks? Well, emerging risks are new or future hazards that may occur in the food chain and cause potential health problems. And when I say hazards, what I mean is chemicals or microorganisms such as bacteria and viruses. We're also interested in re-emerging risks. These are hazards, chemicals, microorganisms, with which we're already familiar, but for which new information has come to light. Now, an example of new information could be a change in the exposure to these particular hazards. Now, this could come about through finding the hazard in a different part of the food chain. An example of this would be bacteria that we're used to seeing in meat-to-meat products suddenly appearing in fresh fruit and vegetables, and that we would call a re-emerging risk. The reason that we're doing this work is anticipation. What we want to do is to try to anticipate new issues, food safety issues that could occur. And we do this through two different activities. First of these is monitoring information, so typically the scientific literature, but also the surveillance programs that already take place across Europe. So one of the types of data that we're interested in is trade data. And here we would like to know what types of food commodities are being traded and what sorts of volumes. Second activity is talking to experts. And to do this, we have two particular networks. Our first network consists of representatives from food safety authorities from across Europe and the European Commission. And the second network, what we call our stakeholders network, consists of representatives from the food industry, from across the whole food chain, from farm to fork, and also consumer associations. Now, through these means, we want to identify new food safety issues in order to be prepared. And what can we do to be prepared? Well, what we want to do is to increase our understanding of these new issues. And we can do this through stimulating research or specific monitoring programs for those issues that we've identified. The aim of all of this is prevention. And this we can carry out through EFSA providing the risk manager, in this case the European Commission, with meaningful information to enable them to prioritise what preventative activities that they can put in place to ensure that those issues that we've identified don't become future food safety crises. We want to do this to maintain the high level of food safety that we have across Europe. This is all part of the activity that takes place at a European level to ensure that your food remains safe.